Welcome to Project 316. I'm your minister of metal, Stephen Taylor. We're going to dive right down to the word, which this week's word is Eyes on Jesus. Crossbringers Church, I know it's hard in our everyday lives when we go through our trials and our tribulations of our life. You know, we're saved Christians, and sometimes our bad things that happen in our lives, they come apart, they drag us down. And sometimes it's hard to focus on Jesus. Sometimes it's hard to focus on Christianity. Sometimes it's hard to just be that Christian, to be that special person that you are for your co-workers, the people that you go to school with, your family. It's a hard thing, especially when you got people around you that give you a hard time, treat you badly. The devil's trying to get you down, and his armies of darkness trying to beat you down. And sometimes it's hard to just to pick yourself up sometimes. You know, I know exactly how that is. And I said the past couple of months for me, it's been pretty difficult. I've got things over here confusing me, but on the other hand, I've got people that are asking me questions, depending on me to pray on them. Now see, Crossbringers, we can't let people down. Too much rides on us when we are called to that great commission to be a Christian. You know, when those things bring us down, we just can't be saying, you know, I just can't do this. It's just too hard. But when we got people that are looking to us to represent God, you know, we gotta be strong. You know, we've got to be that strong horse that pulls people through the mud. See, the outside world, a lot of people who are skeptics or unbelievers, or growing up they never knew God, or they did know God but they went to some kind of church or school or something like that, where they asked a lot of questions but they were told, well, this is the way that it's going to be, and that's going to be how you're going to do it. As a Christian, when I testify to people, I like to say, challenge me. Ask me all those questions. Focus on that. But to be that representative of those people, we need to focus on Jesus. Now see, Crossbringers, the past couple of months, I've had a lot of issues come at me. Harsh. I get through one, here comes another. But the thing that I learned about this situation, that I have to focus on Jesus. Jesus is saying to me, you know what, you've got this going on, but focus on me. Eyes on me. I'm going to lead you throughout this, but you got to do what I say. It's obedience. Obedience to Jesus Christ is what gets us through these situations. Now, it's hard. It's very hard, especially if you're a new Christian. If you've got this hard situation that you've seen that you just can't get through, how can I focus on Jesus? I've never really seen him. I've never physically touched him. But let me tell you, out of experience, Crossbringers, Jesus has never once led me astray. And trust me, I've doubted him numerous times. There's been situations where I come across like, this is just impossible. There's nothing you could do. I might as well just fold. And Jesus say, nah, eyes on me. Keep your eyes on me. You got this other stuff on the side, but focus on me. They're coming at you, but just keep on following me. Following me. And slowly, Jesus is backing up. And he's just telling you, focus on me. Focus on me. Now this scripture, when Jesus is actually first starting his ministry, he goes out to a boat, bunch of fishermen, picks up one of his first 12 disciples with him. And this is where he's teaching. Focus on me. I'm not going to lead you astray. And this scripture comes from Luke 5, 4 through 6. Put out in the deep water and let down nets for a catch. Jesus is telling them, I'm telling you to put out these nets. See, the fishermen before that, they've been working all day long. No catch, no fish. Along comes this man, Jesus, saying, hey, put those nets down right there. Now these guys are looking, that's impossible. We've been all around these waters fishing. And you're just going to come along and tell me put it there? But Jesus is saying, look at me. focus on me, eyes on me, eyes on me. Just walk towards me. And the scripture goes on and says, Simon answered, Master, we've worked all day and night and haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the nets. See? Now Simon's starting to follow Jesus. He's got all these doubts on him. He's got all these problems. He may have had a bill to pay. Or a tax collector coming at him saying, you got to pay this tax by today. He could have had all these worries going at him. But Simon says, okay, you say so, I'm going to do it. So he's starting to follow him. When they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish that their nets begin to break. Now let me tell you something, Crossbringers. There's been times where I look at that same situation. But I say, Jesus, okay, I don't understand it. But if you say so, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. What else you got to lose? Like I said, church, Jesus is not going to lead you astray. Obediently follow him. Another apostle that I've said throughout the messages, one of my favorite apostles, Matthew. He was a tax collector. When Jesus is walking along, he looks at Matthew. Now, Matthew's got all these people, they hate him. Matthew don't care. He's got money. He's a tax collector. I'm sure he's got his burdens like everybody else does. But along comes this man Jesus, turns to him. And the scripture goes like this. As Jesus went from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting in the tax collector's booth. And this is what he said. I love this. He said, follow me. Eyes on me. Come on, let's go. Let's go. And he told him. And Matthew got up and he followed him. Just got up and followed him. Eyes on him. So I need you to think about this, Crossbringers. You know, when the world is against you and you think that you're the underdog, nobody's betting on you, you think that you've got nothing else for you, Jesus is saying, focus on me. Look at me. Follow me. Just keep on following me. Slowly, slowly, but follow me. You may not understand the direction. Jesus may be taking you through twists and turns. And you're like, nah, this is dangerous. I'm not comfortable with this. But Jesus is saying, no, trust me. I'm going to take you to the place where you're going to become stronger. I'm going to take you to the place where it's going to better benefit you and other people as well. But you got to trust me. You got to follow me. We need to remember that. We need to remember that for us, for our families, and the people that we minister to. We can't just look at that twist and turn that looks scary and dangerous, or you may not understand and think, nah, I got to go back. I can't do it. You do that, you're going to end up in a hole. I've been there. Even though it looks dangerous and shaky, Jesus is saying, I'm right here. Let's go. We're going to make it. Follow me. Keep your eyes on me. So let me tell you something, Crossbringers. When you're broke and you ain't got no money, just say, follow me. Follow me. I get you out. Gotta have that faith in me. When you're thinking that you're going to get fired from a job, just say, I got something better for you. Follow me. Keep on with me. When you're in a situation when you may lose your house, your car, Jesus said, just follow me. I will get you there. You may go through some hard times in the process, but you're going to get there. Now, a good friend of mine I go to church with, Shane, awesome guy, met him a couple weeks ago. I asked him, you know, I got a lot of confusion going on. You know, sometimes when I look in the church that I go to, during praise and worship, I look around and I could feel some of the negative energies that are going on. But Shane's telling me, you're not supposed to be focusing on that. When you're in praise and worship, you focus on Jesus. So that's what I did. Instead of looking around like, oh man, they look fake. Oh, they're not really worshiping, they're showboating. Nah, I'm looking up. I'm focused on, I got my eyes closed, and I'm slowly walking. I'm going to get there, Jesus. I'm going to get there. That's what we need to do. Have that faith. It's going to be hard. I know it's going to be hard, Crossbringers. But we just got to follow Jesus. Follow him all the way. And I tell you what, when you follow him and you get to that spot where God and Jesus want you to be, you're going to be able to show that to other people. And that way, when they get into their life's pitfalls, Jesus is going to be right there following them. And you're going to be there to say, you know what? I had those doubts too. I had them. But you know what? I kept on following. And you keep on following Jesus, and you're going to get to where I'm at. And they're going to look at you, and they're going to say, man, everything's going for you. You got it. That's going to give them the motivation. That is our job as Christians, to give people hope, to show them the grace of Christ. Not to be hypocritical or backstabbing or gossiping. To be Jesus Christ's example. Focus on them. Keep focus. That's how we can make a better world, Crossbringers. That's how we're going to do it. So I'm going to tell you, if you're in a position right now and you're feeling low, just raise your hands up. And just close your eyes. And just focus on Jesus. Focus on him. Say, I see you. I see you, and I'm going to keep on following you. I may not understand where you're taking me, Lord, but I'm going. I'm going, and I'm going to keep on going, and I'm not going to stop until you say we're there. I want you to think about that, Crossbringers, when you bump into that situation where you think that all is lost. Follow Jesus. That's going to wrap up our message for this week. Our praise and worship from Wolves at the Gate, Dead Man. I love how this music video, the story of the music video, that shows through a person's hard times, the things that they have done in their past, and even in the end, they could turn around. Even close to the end, any point in your life, you can turn around. You can be a person that is forgiven, that accepts Christ. It is never too late in this life, unless it's before death. We cannot live for tomorrow. But I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you got any prayer requests, please drop by my Facebook, Facebook.com/Project316. Hit me up on my Facebook. You got any testimonies, you got any prayer requests, please share them with Project 316. Or if you want to do it privately, you can go through my email, Project316@hotmail.com. Hey, if you're in a band and you're a Christian band and you want something played on Project 316, I'll play your band. Give me a lyric video and I'll play your stuff. No problems. As long as it's in the Word of God, I have no problem playing it. I encourage you guys to give me any music that you guys got so I can get your names out there. You know, God bless, be blessed, and bring it to the cross.
I've been chorus of death.